Well, Deepika Laurent joins us now for a look at what's making news around the world. Good morning, Deepika. A lot of focus being given, of course, to two men, Emmanuel Macron and Donald Trump.
That's right. A lot of focus, Will, from the French papers as Emmanuel Macron heads to Washington for his three-day official visit and meeting with Donald Trump. He will, of course, be hoping to put pressure on Donald Trump on a number of topics, including getting him to stick to the Iranian nuclear deal. L'Opinion, which is a right-wing paper here in France, says it's very much a big formal fuss, interspersed with some working meetings. And in their daily cartoon here, you see the French president riding a rooster as he meets his buddy Trump, who himself is riding an eagle that kind of looks like the Twitter logo. And you see right down the bottom, it's actually emblazoned with Twitter. Macron is America's friend. That friendship, though, could be tested, particularly if they don't find agreement on the Iranian nuclear deal. Now, that's why La Croix, the Catholic paper, has gone with this headline, Trump-Macron, the paradoxical agreement, in particular on the Iranian nuclear deal. The editors say that getting Donald Trump to change his mind will require all the energy of Emmanuel Macron and all the robustness of the German Chancellor Angela Merkel, who's due to visit shortly afterwards. Old Europe, I quote, knows better than anyone else that peace is worth all that effort.
Also makes you wonder about that expression, birds of a feather flock together. Well, the left-leaning Liberation dedicating its front page to the visit in the U.S. Headline, American Nightmare, giant image of a cheeseburger, as well as some things we might find in trade.
That's right. Libé is always keen to stand out with its front pages. They often do have very, very good headlines. Today, it's looking at what it calls the American nightmare. In other words, all that's wrong with American society, rising inequality, a, quote, anachronistic electoral system, faulty infrastructure. The editors call the country a strangeness. America's democracy is intransigent and plutocratic, idealist and unequal, creative and conformist. It's a country whose future fascinates us, they say, but it's not a future that we in Europe desire. Perhaps to atone for its harsh criticism of American society, Libé has dedicated one page to all the things that it loves about the U.S., including Brooklyn Lager, Snoop Dogg, doggy bags, the Parkland High School students, Leonardo DiCaprio, and, I quote, the greasy dishes of soul food.
All right. Well, at least they got a few of our best elements on that. Well, from the Macron-Trump bromance, a relationship that's a bit more complicated, that of Narendra Modi, the Indian Prime Minister, and Chinese President Xi Jinping.
That's right. Narendra Modi, the Indian Prime Minister, is heading to central China this week for an informal summit with President Xi Jinping, the Chinese leader. Narendra Modi will actually be going back to China in June for a regional summit as well. And according to the South China Morning Post, it's actually quite unusual for a foreign leader to visit the same country twice in such a short time. According to analysts, it could help the two Asian giants reset ties. This after last year's military standoff in the disputed Himalayan region of Doklam. They've also squabbled over Beijing's infrastructure project, the Belt and Road Initiative, as both are, of course, competing for regional dominance. Now, one writer from the Hindustan Times, an Indian paper, says perhaps the instability of the world right now is actually bringing these two leaders together, as both share concerns about a crumbling global system. Despite their differences, several sources say that President Xi actually sees India as a stabilizing force, and he even admires Narendra Modi's ability to carry out economic reforms. So I guess in times of crisis, enemies can become friends.
Indeed. All right. Well, finally, from Deepika, a story of a young American man who seems to be quite unlucky.
That's right. Three times unlucky, yeah. You might say, Will. Le Figaro reports that an American man, a 20-year-old man called Dylan McWilliams, was bodyboarding recently in Honolulu when a tiger shark grabbed his leg. He thought he might lose his leg, but luckily he was able to swim to safety. This would seem like a scary experience in itself, but Dylan has actually explained to a local American TV station that he was bitten by a snake recently, or quite a few years ago. And last July, he had to have stitches after, get this, he woke up in a Colorado campsite with his head between the jaws of a bear.
All right, so warning to Dylan and his friends, beware before you go on vacation. Dipti Gaurang with a roundup of the headlines. She'll be back a couple hours later with a look at more international news. That's it for now. Stay tuned. More headlines coming up in just a moment.